What's up, Facebook? How are you cool cobras doing this fine afternoon? Got the wands shipped out today. So they'll be shipping out over the weekend. For those of you who ordered wands from the latest batch, thank you. I greatly appreciate it. For those of you who want another, for those of you who want a wand, who haven't gotten one yet, I will be making more wands shortly. I'll take like 3 or 4 days off between each batch. That'll give me time to collect sticks and get what I need. Indeed, CJ, happy Friday. What's up, Richie Relt? What's up, Anthony? Good evening, Carla. How you doing? Yeah. I hope there are multicolored wands. Well, you see that in the background, big old fat roll of painter's tape. So I might be able to pull something like that off. I can do rainbow colored wands for my batches. I have no problem with that. They just take a little bit longer to paint. Gothic D says her wands are the real deal. There's no such thing as gay magic, Anthony. If whoever this person is, if you know what I'm saying, I'm gonna remove that comment. Delete. Delete. There is a person, and if it is Gothic D selling wands, I don't care. The chances are it's a troll trying to create more drama between the two of us. So they're pretending to be Gothic D, pretending to sell wands, just to fucking smite my business and create more drama on social media. And quite frankly, it's sickening. These people just need to leave Gothic D the fuck alone. Like, that's old news. You know, that YouTube battle happened a long time ago. There's no sense in continuing to drag it out. You know, I'm fucking sick of it. And it's like I said in my video last night, dude, like, you want to pick on someone, pick on me. You know, why are you picking on chicks just because I associate with them? And that's the thing of it. You know, the whole thing started because I got a shout out and returned the favor. One of my trolls started hitting on her and saying, "Oh, you should get with him, blah, blah, blah." And she's like, "How's that gonna work? I'm halfway around the world and I already have somebody, blah, blah, blah." And that just created a bunch of unnecessary shit. Customizing a BB gun. Are you getting your pizza on again tonight? If by getting it on you mean finishing the pizza that I have left, then yes. No, it's St. Patrick's Day, so I might try to go hang out with some friends, see what they're all up to. You can see the Daisy Red Rider that I'm customizing sitting right there on my on top of some paint cans on the workbench. I took a hacksaw and I pistol gripped the Daisy Red Rider to give it that bootleg, the bootleg sort of look. And then I'm repainting the wood on the BB gun glow in the dark. And then I'm painting all the black on the BB gun gold. Trying to give it that gangster's paradise sort of look, you know. Yeah. And it should be cool when it's all said and done. I made a video on YouTube cutting the stock off and doing a couple of other things to it, you know, removing the leather from the loop and the little loop around the forearm. Yeah. Oh, there's someone who has a birthday coming up, and I think they're really going to like this BB gun when it's all said and done. Part one was just where you see it's at right now, you know, getting the first half of it painted. Part two will be untaping it, taping it back up on the wood and painting the black parts gold. But to make anything you want glow in the dark with spray paint, you have to apply a base coat of white, and then you gotta let it dry solid before you add the glow-in-the-dark paint. Then you let that dry. I mean, I got a little bit of white paint on my pants, but I don't care.
Yeah.
I don't. I even bought a fresh container of Daisy BBs to go with it, you know. It's enough to get whoever owns this BB gun started, you know. Yeah. I'm telling you, Facebook, this BB gun's gonna kick ass when it's done. I just got that feeling. I suppose I could heat up a slice of pizza, but I just got done eating a slice not too long ago, so I'm not particularly hungry at the moment. But yeah, YouTube and Facebook, this BB gun's gonna look sick as shiznit when it's done. Yeah. Which a point that I made on my YouTube video is some diehard Red Ryder fans are gonna consider that very sacrilegious. Like, you devilish bastard, you sanctified the original piece. What the f is wrong with you? And some people are gonna be like, man, forget those guys, it's gonna look sick when it's done. I'm like, yeah, only time will tell. I picked up a bag of cherry pipe tobacco because it's delicious. So I just got done filming the video of part one, and right now I'm letting that white paint dry solid with no stickiness before I add the glow-in-the-dark paint and let that dry nice and solid. And then part two will be taking all that painter's tape off and retaping the grips, retaping it on the grips, and painting the black parts gold. Excuse me. which might have to be done in sections. That way I'm not making a huge mess painting it. If only continue using the paint cans to support it while it dries, then I'm gonna have to paint it in sections. When I do the gold paint, otherwise, you know, yeah. I was dripping paint all over the place when I was painting it earlier because I got the first two coats on like that. I went to a Home Depot and I couldn't find the copper wire I was looking for. So I ended up going to Walmart and getting something different for the handles this time. This is what I got from my next batch of wands. I'll be using this stuff for handles. Kind of a goldish, yellowish, copperish looking. Yeah. That'll make the handles look nice. Excuse me. But yeah, I'm actually pretty excited to watch this BB gun turn out. I think it's going to be sick as balls when it's done. Sick as tits, I mean, yeah, however the expression goes. I try to picture a BB gun that a mob boss would own. And that's kind of the theme I'm going for, you know. You see these gold-plated guns on YouTube with the pearl grips, and you're just like, ooh, shiny. And that's pretty much the theme I'm going for with this BB gun. Howdy, Shane. What's up? Chris Hubble says, would... Homeboy Scotty is chilling somewhere. I don't know where he is specifically, but I just talked to him earlier and he seemed to cheer up a little bit when I talked to him, so that's good. Am I sick? Sick in the head, probably, Carla, but am I sick in general? No, I don't feel sick. My sinuses aren't stuffed up. I don't have excessive mucus. It's probably the start to a smoker's cough, to be honest. I've been smoking since I was 18 and I'm almost 28, so. Yeah. But I'd be cutting down on my tobacco use. I don't do it as much just because it gets expensive. And I feel like the nicotine will hit me harder if I don't do it as much. Pack a bowl of that tobacco nice and quick. But I do love the smell of cherry pipe tobacco. That's tasty stuff, YouTube. Do you make your bed with military corners? Well, I don't know how to do that exactly, but yes, I do make my bed. Ha 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 ha. Yes, I do know what you're saying, Carla. I imagine if you're old enough to partake in, on the sweet leaf, and you live in a state where it's legal, and you smoke every day, eventually you're going to build a tolerance to it. So you'd have to slow down smoking or smoke less or stop smoking completely to get your THC tolerance to go back down. But if they're going to test people for driving under the influence of THC, if they're going to make pot legal and they're going to prevent DUIs from happening, then testing someone for THC when they're driving, they could have smoked that joint or that blunt like 2 weeks ago, and that THC is still going to be in their system. You know what I'm saying? So if they're going to test people for driving stoned, which is something you shouldn't do, you should always drive sober. I don't care what the substance is. I don't care how good of a driver you think you are. Drive sober or get pulled over. It's just that simple. And when you're driving, focus on your surroundings and what you're doing with your car. Don't be sitting there fucking texting and driving and calling people while you're driving. That's not smart, people. When you're driving, it should be a distraction-free zone. And the only time you should have anything in your hand, if anything, is you're smoking a cigarette while you're driving, or a cigar, maybe you're puffing on your pipe or whatever. And maybe you're at a stoplight and you decide to change the song, and the stoplight's staying red for a good minute, so you got time to reach down and, fiddle with your radio a bit. You know what I'm saying? When you're driving a car, you want to be primarily just basically focused on the road and being a safe and responsible driver. A safe, responsible, and respectful driver. You know what I'm saying? Because that's how accidents happen, man, is when people are being careless with their driving. I cannot tell you how many times I've gotten hit because drivers were not paying attention. And it's a good thing that I'm paying attention when I'm riding my bike. Otherwise, nobody else would. And I'd have to get up off my bike and kick a motherfucker's ass. And be like, you scratched my bike, you scratched me up, and now I'm going to scratch you up. Hope you like the taste of going through your windshield. I've been hit by a car. It's not fun. That's why you gotta look both ways before crossing the street. Yeah. That wrecked my motorized scooter to hell and back, but it is what it is. And maybe if I had looked both ways before crossing the street, I'd still be driving it. Hard to say. But that's what life does to you. You live and you let learn from all your bullshit and your mistakes. You shouldn't smoke, it's bad for you. Is. Says the guy who's smoking a pipe. Huh. No, but with pipe tobacco, you can run the risk of getting throat cancer, mouth cancer, and lung cancer if you inhale. End up having like one of those giant ass holes in your throat. Yeah. So smoking a pipe does have health risks, just like smoking a cigarette, but I feel like there's less of a chance because pipe tobacco generally has less chemicals. But yeah. I don't try to glamorize smoking, I really don't. You know, I can't help it if people are drawn to wanting to smoke a pipe if they smell it or they see me do it on camera. Like, oh, hey, that smells good. That's the problem with smoking tobacco, is you run the risk of getting a humongous hole in your throat. And they have this device that makes you sound like this. Yeah. If. And that's something that, like, as a smoker, that's like in the back of my mind. I'm like, well, I'm not old enough where it's seriously going to affect me, but. Dude. Chilling out like an old school rock star, milling for reeling on Facebook Live. Just drive. Did Ben Dobbins recover from his spectrum surgery all right? Haven't a separate. I hope he did. I really do. What about Shatter? Oh yeah, that stuff's potent, man. That's concentrated THC. That shit'll fuck you up. You gotta get like this torch going. Then you heat up your dab nail, and your dab bong, whatever. Or unless you have like an electric nail. And then you drop the wax in there or the shatter, and then. You think the weed makes you cough? I would imagine that shatter makes you cough a lot more. Although I couldn't tell you personally. Oh, wait. I've been to Colorado a couple of times. If you're old enough to purchase from a dispensary and you go to a state where it's recreationally legal, you can buy it. And then, like, maybe your friend has a cousin that lives in Colorado, what have you. You go to their house to smoke up, and he ain't gonna get fucked with. Which is the smart way to do it. No, the fact that cannabis is illegal is so flippin' stupid. It's so flippin' stupid. YouTube and Facebook, it's unbelievable. You know, cannabis oil that's high in CBD can treat children who have epilepsy. Charlotte's Web, I might add, is a beautiful strain. And when you're seeing a plant do something like that, it's like, hey, that's what's up, Anthony. Hell yeah. Anthony says you can buy weed here in California, lots of dispensaries. Oh, I believe it, dude. That is awesome that California legalized it for recreational use. You'd be 21 walking down the street puffing out a blunt, and they ain't gonna say shit. Unless you're near a dispensary or near a school, then they might have a stink about it, but then, you know, which is understandable, you know. Even though marijuana is like the safest drug out there, you still don't want to expose kids to it unless their doctor recommends it, or unless they need it for a medical issue. Yeah. I mean, it's cool to get stoned, but you know, if you get stoned and then take on no responsibility in your life, you give stoners a bad name. There's a reason why stoners are stereotypically labeled as lazy. Because a lot of people like to smoke, sit on their ass, eat Doritos, and play video games. Which there's nothing wrong with that. You gotta make time for yourself. But if that's all you do is sit on your ass and smoke, you know. You don't get out and try to have some sort of life, make a living, you know. That's no way to live. It's cool to get stoned and high, but it's not cool to just, that's all you do. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta have some responsibility in your life, Facebook. And these lazy stoners are no different than the people who get drunk and they get violent. It gives people who drink alcohol a bad name. You ever see an emotional drunk? They get violent, or they get sobby, and they cry about everything, or they get really excited and they're just super energetic and super clumsy. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's all about knowing your limit, people. And it's cool to catch a buzz and have a good time when you're old enough. But you gotta be responsible with that shit, man. Like, I get so fucking tired of these people who party, have a good time, and they're irresponsible with it. And then if people find out that you do certain things like drink or what XYZ, they kind of look at you like, oh, so I guess you're either really violent or really lazy, huh? Like, no. That's just a cliche, man. Suppose the smell of cherry pipe tobacco is a bit more pleasing to the nose than the smell of spray paints, but man. I mean, if I stay home for the rest of the evening, there's a good chance I'll get that BB gun done in one night. That's not going to be a problem. It's a project and it's given me something to do. So, yeah. That video took long enough to upload to my desktop. Holy sh! So I'll go ahead and get part one uploaded. Come on, come on, you can do it. Yeah, there we go. I'm not gonna bother monetizing it because the word guns in it, and you try to monetize it, and YouTube might take your monetization for that video away because, oh, well, you know. Guns are just like pit bulls. It's not the pit bull or the gun's fault that people are stupid with them. You know? Well, that's just the thing of it. One pit bull attacks a couple of fourth graders, and everyone's fighting tooth and nail to get pit bulls banned. You don't see him making that same argument with AR-15s. Oh. I'm not saying we should ban AR-15s or pit bulls. I'm just saying that, you know, it's not the gun's fault, it's not the dog's fault. It's the owner's fault, you know. Do you know how many people in Wyoming own AR-15s? Plenty of responsible gun owners do. They use them to hunt, plink, you know. And some people might be like, well, isn't 25 rounds a bit excessive for hunting? Maybe to you it is, but what if you miss? And that's the thing of it. A lever action Winchester holds the same cartridge as an AR-15. But because the AR-15 looks like a scary military weapon, and because it's been used in a lot of mass shootings, people tend to have a negative view towards it, which is understandable. But if you're letting, you know, if you're giving these mass shooters exactly what they want when you sit there and call it an evil gun, because even after the shooting's done, they still want you to have fear and panic and all that sort of bullshit. And you're giving them exactly what they want. You're giving them exactly what they want, Facebook. So maybe we should make the sale of AR-15s restricted to 21 years of age or older instead of 18, even though it's a rifle cartridge. Hear me out. You restrict the sales of AR-15s to people 21 years of age or older, and you require stricter background checks for higher capacity guns. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Because that's fair for both sides. Because if you try to take away the AR-15, everyone in the country that supports guns is going to be like, you can't do that. That's the Second Amendment right. And they're right. It is. You know? But when I hear these people making a bitch fit about bump stocks getting banned, I'm like, well, that's kind of pushing it. I mean, they have every right to ban them, especially if they're being used. But then, of course, you get these people on social media. You get these people on social media who will justify that by saying, well, first it's the bump fire stock, then next it's your entire gun. Yeah, that's the thing of it. You know what I'm saying? They'll have an easier time banning a bump fire stock than they will an actual gun. You know what I'm saying? Within reason. You know what I'm saying? And this is why machine guns and sawed-off shotguns are illegal. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And it's ridiculous, Facebook. It's ridiculous. So I think if you want to buy an AR-15, you have to be 21 or older, and you have to have a stricter background check because it holds more ammo. You know what I'm saying? That doesn't take the AR-15 away from our gun-loving country, and, you know, it puts a little bit more security on who's buying them and who's going out the door with them, you know? And if you're a responsible gun owner, you know what I'm saying? What's a couple extra days? You know what I'm saying? Facebook, like, for real. Because this is the thing of it. The way it sits. Maybe you have $50 here, $60 there. You can order parts to build your own AR-15 and then assemble it at home. You don't even need to go to a gun store. If you have the proper tools and the proper training and the expertise and the money, you can buy all the parts and build it at home yourself, you know? And that's, I mean, I like guns, but to me, that's kind of a scary concept. You know what I'm saying? Like, I like guns as much as the next true-blooded American, but the idea that you can order parts super cheap and then assemble a fully working gun and without anyone knowing, and of course you have to register it before you could use it, but do you think that's going to stop people by the time they, you know what I'm saying? Like, as soon as you say I like guns, everyone either will support you or they'll look at you like, what state are you from? Wyoming, yeah, figures. What? Have you seen the bumper sticker? Welcome to Wyoming. Consider everybody armed and dangerous. But And that's the thing, I mean, you're going to encounter that kind of crap with any scenario. You're going to get people who support your cause, then you're going to get people who look at you like, well, aren't you special? You know, assuming that just because someone loves guns, there's some radical right-wing extremist who hates minorities, and it, you know, that's just a negative stereotype. That's no different than, you know, if you use the word libtard, no one's going to take you seriously. You know what I'm saying, Facebook? And you hear these would-be rednecks, oh, these fucking libtards and blah, blah, blah. And it's just like, oh, aren't you special? Look at you trying to sound all political and smart. I've never understood why people hate liberals. Because most liberals are for human rights and for equality, which to me doesn't sound like a bad idea. You know, I think if they're too stuck in their ways and they're brainwashed by their political party's news team, you know, these are the brain dead idiots that watch Fox News, and they're probably over the age of 80. And yeah, you know, I mean, when someone comes at you in the argument with these fucking libtards, you just look at them like, are you in fourth grade? What the hell, dude? You sound so immature right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, you try to make yourself sound smart and tough and, oh, politically woke. You know, but you don't sound smart, you don't sound tough, you don't sound politically woke, you sound like a dumbass. It was just being ignorant. Ugh, Facebook, you don't even know the half of it. Like, that felt good to say. A lot of people in chat. What's up, Ben Dobbins? Ben Dobbins says, I'm eating Taco Bell. Hell yeah. I like Taco Bell. I like Taco John's too. You know, I like them both. You can't make me pick a favorite because Taco John's has their potato Lays, delicious. Taco Bell has the Doritos Locos Tacos and the Chalupas. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Yeah. And you know what I'm saying, Facebook? Like, fast food's delicious, but you gotta moderate yourself on that. You know, if you choose to eat nothing but fast food and you gain a shit ton of weight, that's not McDonald's fault. That's not Taco Bell's fault. That's your own damn fault, you know. That'd be like me getting lung cancer and then suing Marlboro for it. Like, you bastards, you know. Like, well, you chose to smoke, dude, so, you know. And that's the thing that gets me about our society. They're so freaking sue happy. Like, if you want to make an honest dollar, then make an honest dollar, you know. Wasting people's times with petty lawsuits. It's just disgusting. He looked at me or she said something I didn't agree with. I'm going to sue you. Oh boy. My lawyers will be in touch. I bet they will. You sound like such a lovely person. Ugh. Ben Dobbins, your surgery must have went good. Happy you're still here. You're eating Taco Bell now. Rattlesnake fries, question mark. Hell yeah. The rattlesnake fries at Taco Bell look pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. But if it doesn't contain actual rattlesnake in it, then you can't call it rattlesnake fries. So I thought about one of these days ordering some rattlesnake beef jerky off the internet and then taking some in a bag with me to Taco Bell and getting some rattlesnake fries and being like making like a little food hack and be like, okay, so this is how you make rattlesnake fries, rattlesnake beef jerky and rattlesnake fries at Taco Bell. So I want some of that Diablo and fire sauce. Yeah. Now, if you're looking for the spiciest kick you can get at Taco Bell, you mix the Diablo and the fire sauce on your taco, both one of each on your taco. Boom. That's the hottest sauce they offer, and it's good. But it'll, you know what I'm saying? If you can't, and if you can't handle spicy, I would not recommend it, because, yeah. And the thing about Taco Bell and Taco John's, their hot sauces are deliberately designed so that your mouth can be cooled off with soda pop. And they do that to make you drink more of their pop. It's a marketing technique, and it works. You ever notice that? You go to Taco Bell, you get some salsa, you get some sauce for your taco, it's spicy, you drink some soda pop, it cools your mouth off, leaves a little bit of spice left on your tongue. You know what I'm saying? They do that because, now think about it, if their hot sauce was so spicy that soda pop wouldn't cool it off, then nobody would drink their soda. So they make their hot sauce just spicy enough to give you a little bit of heat, but you can cool it off with soda. It encourages you to try their frozen ice drinks and what have you, which, if you think about it, is a marketing genius tactic. If you're running a business, that's the way you gotta be. You know what I'm saying? You gotta have smart business tactics. Otherwise, your business will sink. I won't be doing any new burger recipes until I finish my pizza, like I said, because I don't want to waste it. So I'll just heat up a slice real quick while we're chilling and bullshitting. Now, this is that pizza I ordered with that dank pizza video that I made on YouTube recently. And I'll give it a 44-second burst, and if it's warm enough that it's hot, then cool. And then I'm going to take some Doritos and crush them up on top and eat it. Because that just sounds good. Let's see if 44 seconds was enough. That should be in a powerful microwave. Yeah, that was plenty. The microwave I have is pretty powerful, so 44 seconds was plenty to heat up just this little slice right here. And, I mean, if you want to make your pizza tastier, add Doritos to it. I'm just saying. Go ahead and crush a couple up, kind of strategically place them on top here. Crush it up, because that's what's up. I'll be doing a burger with these flaming hot Doritos on YouTube later on. So keep an eye out for that. Been a while since I've done a spicy bacon cheeseburger for YouTube, so yeah. That looks pretty good. What do you think, Facebook? Would you eat it? I'd eat it. I'm gonna go ahead and eat this slice real quick. There's a reason why that YouTube video is called Dank Pizza, because this is Dank Pizza. And then you get the crunch from those nacho cheese Doritos. Yeah, that just brought it to a whole other level. You use whatever flavor of chip you want, but putting chips on top of your pizza, oh yeah. Earlier in the chat, Carlo was like, can you heat up a slice? And I'm like, yeah, maybe. Heat up a slice and food hack it. Yeah. Oh yeah. Glass of water to wash that down. I think I forgot to grab pop when I was at the store, but yeah, that's all right. That's what's going down in my neck of the town. Yeah, buddy. I'll catch you cool cobras later, yo. Bye, Facebook.